So now we are simply going to go to the tutorials, just keep solving ourselves. And again, you know, this problem maybe will take a little bit longer to solve also, because a lot of geometries are usually involved in 3D equilibrium. So we can just go through the steps as such when, you know, we are solving it. So if you can just go through these problems quickly, we'll just work on the tutorial now. So anyway, I'll just explain. These are two bearings here. Okay, and these are T-shaped welded bar. So this total body is continuous. There is no breaking here. So only supported by two bearings at A and B. Okay, and we want to find out the reaction that is coming from the wall. I'm sorry about this. So there is D is that wall, okay? So ultimately, you know, what is the concept here is that taking the moment about the AB axis, but before we do that, you know, we need to kind of convince people, okay, how the bearing reactions are acting, why we are able to do the, you know, why we are able to take the moment about the AB axis. That's the whole issue, okay? Now you take the moment about AB axis, but can we really try to figure out that I do have a, you know, moment, I do have a force from the wall that is along the x-axis. So when you take the moment about the AB axis of that force, which component actually contributes to that, you know, moment about AB? You have a dx that is acting along the x-axis, right? So we need to take the component of that dx, which is perpendicular to the AB. That's all. So we need to find the distance here, and that distance is, you know, typically, if we create a point here, F, let's say this point is F here, and we need to find this FC, which is the perpendicular distance from C to the wall. Okay, so that distance needs to be found out. So that distance, once we know that distance, this problem can be solved very easily. That's the hint. So one have already, you know, one of you has found this thing. The distance D that I was talking about, that is actually perpendicular distance from C to the wall. Okay, so that distance is very, very important. Once we know that distance, and also we need an angle somewhere, because we have to now kind of, you know, because we have this dx here, the dx has to be rotated, okay, such that it is again perpendicular to the line AB. Okay, so once we do that, right, then we can simply take the moment very easily. So 375 Newton is the answer. Just quickly show you the information that we need. So the, basically we are looking at this distance. That distance is stated as FC. Okay, so there is F, and this FC should be equals to 300. That is the first thing. Second thing is that, see, ultimately we can see there is a theta here. That theta needs to be calculated, because we want to take the component of the dx, right, which is again parallel to the CF. That's okay. So ultimately, you know, we have this small d is understood, that d here, right, that d is actually the length FC, small d. Okay, so this is the equation that is important. This is the only equation that is required to solve this problem. Okay, P multiplied by D over 2, because you have this D is actually FC, and then we have DX sin theta. So that sin theta component will be, right, parallel to the FC. Okay, and then you multiply that by 300 to get the moment about AB. So the final answer will be 375 Newton, as one of you have answered. So okay, the moment about an axis here, again, is very important, you know, and also geometry plays an important role that we have seen. So let's move on to the next problem. As such, it will actually take, you know, all the problems will take minimum half an hour. So let us just move on to the next problem. It's a very popular problem, I would say. Okay, it is given in all the, you know, courses that I have seen so far. And it's nice to look at also because, you know, we play with this thing in day-to-day life. So we have the tripod here. And just remember, some of the things that we have to keep in mind is the camera is uniformly, weight of the camera is uniformly distributed, okay? So the camera weight is uniformly distributed, which should pass through its mass center, own mass center. And also the line of action of the weight of the tripod that is said to be passing through D. The D point is here. So the vertical components of the reactions at A, B, and C, we have to find when theta is equals to zero. Now what is important is this camera is being moved, is being rotated about the y-axis, okay? And we want to find out that when it is going to actually tip off. All right, the tip off condition is very important. So this problem is given just to, you know, understand that what is the tip off condition? When the tip off will happen? Okay, so first part is as such, you know, very straightforward. So we make the theta equals to zero. So what happens? So all the, if you look at the weight that is coming from the tripod and also the weight that is coming from the camera, they should all pass through a maximum value of theta. Sorry. Again, you know, these are all conversion problem, I mean. So the maximum value of theta, we keep on moving the camera, right? Rotating the camera. What is the maximum value of theta if the tripod is not to tip over? So we need to look at, you know, this problem from the top view. So we just have to make sure that we draw the free body diagram in this plane. All the forces again will be acting perpendicular to this plane. All the forces that we see, they are acting perpendicular to the plane that is relevant to this problem. Okay? So we draw the free body diagram only on that plane. And these are all parallel force systems. Again, we are looking at all parallel force system, and those forces are going to be perpendicular to this. So reactions are vertical. We are going to get the vertical reactions from A, B, and C. That's all. Okay, now draw that free body diagram on this plane with all the forces. Those are actually parallel force system we have. As such, it's a, you know, it does have some computation, as if, especially for this part, we are going to do, you know, a lot of computation. But this part is very straightforward. That answer, at least, we should be able to do it. The idea is here that we are rotating the camera. Okay, the camera is rotated about the y-axis. So as you keep doing that, what happens? The mass center of the camera is going to be shifted also, right? And what happens? What is the basic concept? Can we imagine that there is a line AC? If you draw this line AC and think of moment about AC, to topple over, what will happen is that we have one force that is coming from the tripod. The other force we also coming from the mass center. Right? So now these two will create an equivalent system as if. And when that force, that equivalent force is actually going, you know, on the other direction of the line AC, it is going to topple. So ultimate condition for the toppling will be? What is the condition for the tip over? The reaction at the B will be equals to zero. That is the condition we have to use. So at the verge of tipping, RB equals to 0. So the question was, it is not to tip over, that means RB or BY, let's say. So BY should be greater than 0. As long as BY is greater than 0, it is not going to tip over. So I'll quickly, you know, show you the free body diagram, I think, just a hint to this problem. I think ultimately, how do you draw the, free body diagram? See, this is the part A, free body diagram. Okay, so this is the, you know, point D through which the weight of the tripod, is 0.44 pound, right? And the camera, right? So camera weight, that is going to be acting at a distance of 1.4 inch, because if we look at the mass center of the camera, right? So that is going to be 1.4 inch away from the D. Why? Because, see, ultimately it is 4.8 divided by 2, so 2.4 negative 1, right? So that should be the distance of the mass center from D, 2.4 negative 1, okay? So that's how we draw the free body diagram, which is very, very important. And the rest of the procedure will easily follow now. So now how do I find out A in one go? The AY can be found out by taking the moment about the line BC. And someone already said the answer is going to be 0.65 pound. Okay. Similarly, what we can do, we can try to find out either B or C by taking the moment about x-axis. Right, so B and C, that equation, what is the relationship between B and C? So that they are equal in this case, okay. In this case, it is fine, but ultimately, we have to also make use of the vertical equilibrium condition. So AY plus BY plus CY equals to the force. So from there, we can actually solve for the BY and CY. So in the first case, yes, they are equal, okay, BY and CY. So in the second problem, what is basically happening? I will again show the free body diagram. So procedure is going to be same. So this is the free body diagram. Ultimately, this theta needs to be found. So I have rotated the camera. So mass center has been moved by this theta. So remember, this 1.4 inch is still there, right? So only concern is this theta, which we have to find. And the condition is that not to tip over, BY should always be greater than 0. So ultimately, find the expression for BY in terms of theta. That's what we have to do. And once we say that expression is established, so BY just greater than equals to 0, we'll solve for the theta. Okay. There is also an important part here, as I said, that one can also think of this problem like this. If we join AC, right? Okay, there is a line. See, ultimately what is happening, if we study this problem very carefully, these two makes an equivalent system that is located somewhere between, let's say, D and this point. Okay, as we keep rotating the camera, right? Okay. And ultimately, what will happen, that equivalent force, as soon as it actually cuts the AC line, then immediately BY will be equals to 0. Because if we take the moment of everything about the line AC, okay? So that procedure can also be adopted. That also we can. I mean, it's a bit lengthy problem, and definitely it is not going to be an exam problem, I won't say, but it is going to be more or less a homework problem. But condition of tipping is something that we have to, you know, impart to the student very carefully. So the answer, if we want to find out, we have to go through the process. So ultimately setting up an expression for BY, that we can do. Now, how do we set up the expression for BY? One is that we take the moment about the x-axis, that is already done. So you get a relationship between CY and BY now. Okay. Other thing that we should do, take the moment about an axis that is parallel to Z but passing through A. So let's say axis AZ. If we take the moment about this, then again we can have an equation that is relating BY and CY. So from these two equations, we solve for BY in terms of theta and then say BY is greater than 0. So these are again, so far we had basically, you know, a single rigid body action. Now we just study also the multi-body actions, okay? So all the connections are here ball and socket joint. There are three members. Everything is a ball and socket joint. And the question is posed very, very carefully. Use only three equilibrium conditions to find X component of reactions at C, B, and A. So first part, let us just try to do that, and then others can follow. We can try to find out what are the number, how many unknowns are there, how many equations we have. Just a hint, because we have already studied 2D equilibrium. Now in 3D, is there any two force member in this body, in this frame? Is there any two force member? BE is a two force member. Why? Because they are connected by pins. It is almost pins because ball and socket joint, now it forms a pin. So to hold the equilibrium, the net reaction has to be equal and opposite. Okay. So therefore, at the very far beginning, we have to understand that BY equals to 0 and EY equals to 0. Because it's a two force, it becomes a two force member. You have only axial load in BE, okay? And due to that, we should not have any BY and EY. Now we can start solving. Now the issue will be very, very simple. So that's the only concept that is required here, because no lateral load is applied in BE. It is simply ball and socket joint at the two ends, right? And therefore, it will only carry the axial load in this problem. Now this is a typical, you know, final exam problem actually. So CX is 2, that is correct. AX is the answer. The minus plus is an issue, definitely, how we have chosen, but magnitude is not correct. AX should be 0.6, and BX is 2.6. So how do you do that? So, can you take a moment about BY? CX is 2, right? And CX can be found. Moment about Y axis passing through point. So it has to be, you can find it very easily from this free body diagram. DY, take moment about DY. See, in one go, you can find it from that free body only. So in one go, if you really want to find out what is CX, I should take a moment about DY of this particular bar, okay? I take a moment about Y-axis of this bar, that will solve for the CX very easily. So CX is at the top, take the moment about DY. Then we come to that member ABC. In the member ABC, if we take a moment about BY, that will solve for AX. And if we do the sum of force along X direction equals to 0, that we will solve for bx. Okay. So thing will follow like that. So that is why the question was posed that only use three equilibrium conditions to solve for ax, bx, and cx. But see here, what the main intention was to find out that there is a two-force member, and that really, solved the problem very quickly. The rest of the, things, we can just keep taking the various moment and force conditions that we have from various free bodies, but these are all the answers. Is that okay? Done?